Welcome to the Fundamentals of Surveying Q&A video 2020. Question number 3. Time flies. In question number 3, before I even show you the question, I am going to apologize because I'm going to make fun of a political figure. And you know what? You can make fun of any political figure you want to in the comments below because it's all in good fun. If I offend you, my apologies, but I hope you get a laugh. All right, call of the question. The year is 2020. Hillary Clinton is elected president, and she decides to give a $1,000 universal basic income to every U.S. citizen. If you guys don't know what universal basic income is, Google it. Now, the problem is that money doesn't grow on trees. So the U.S. Department of Transportation decides to give back its junkiest 5% of roadway inventory. These are the roadways that nobody uses and cost taxpayers millions. Once these reversions take place, who owns the land underneath the once been roadway? That's not proper English, but give me a pass. So you've got this roadway running through central Arkansas or central California or central wherever. The DOT goes to court and the DOT says to the judge, "Judge, this is a list of roadways. We don't want them anymore. See you later." What are you going to do? Who owns the roadway? Well, the first thing I would do is I'd say this is a legal question. And the two best legal textbooks we can find on the shelf, Brown's Boundary Control and Clark on Surveying. You guys should both own these books, no questions asked. So Brown's Boundary Control is really more the principles, and Clark on Surveying has more meat or more details. But get these books out and read these two books because they will solve this question for you. But if you don't want to spend 6 months reading both of these books, continue watching. The first thing I'm going to say is I sort of tricked you because I did not give you very many details. I just told you that some roadways were being abandoned. What I did not tell you is the roadway in question, was the roadway in question owned by one person, or was the roadway in question split two lots? So in my first hypothetical, there was some land, and it was taken, and they built a road. In my second or red hypothetical, 25 feet was taken from Joe, 25 feet was taken from Sally, and the roadway center line actually is on two different properties, either side. But that's okay, because my trick is going to come back to haunt me in a minute. Once we have our situation, let's ask ourselves a couple of questions. The first question I'm going to ask is, was this fee title or was this an easement right? Now, what I mean by that is the government had some options, and the government could do a few things. The first thing the government could do was they could take your land in fee. That means you have no rights to your property any longer. Write a deed, sign it, pay you, move on. Now, the other thing they could have done is they could have let you keep your land, but they wrote themselves an easement. And guess what? An easement is presumed. So if there is a right-of-way created from your property and the deed does not say fee title, an easement is presumed. Memorize that. Next question. How is the legal description written? Because if you say the Jones Smith property, go northwest along the road, we are going to presume that the deed goes to the center line, but that can be rebutted with evidence. But what I want you to get out of this is it fee title or is it an easement? Because that's going to answer your question in just a minute. So let's talk more about that. When a public roadway is created, it is presumed that the public only gets an easement. When an easement is extinguished, the full rights of the land revert back to the property owner. Now, I should say the current property owner. Because if you own Blackacre with an easement on top of it, and the easement in question is canceled, you still own Blackacre. Nothing's changed. On the other hand, if fee title was conveyed and the public burden is discharged, private rights revive. What do I mean by that? Well, the government purchased a piece of property from you. Then they discharged the burden. You now own your property that you used to own. They gave it back to you. So it reverts to the original owner and his heirs. Okay, get those two things set. And the way I'm going to drill this into your brain is I'm going to give you two hypotheticals. Hypothetical number one, John Brown, farmer, has 10 acres of land. And I'm going to tell you this, he owned all 10 acres. The government shows up with a court order and takes it. Bastards. 65 years later, the Florida DOT says, this road is a joke. You can have it back. So they go to court and they legally abandon all 10 acres. The roadway does not exist in physical form, and the roadway does not exist in legal form. It goes back to John Brown. But 65 years is a long time. John Brown's been dead. So who gets it? John Brown's heirs. This is the situation where it reverts back to the original owner or his heirs. And based on this, since they took the land, this is a fee simple conveyance. Let that percolate in your mind for a minute. Okay, situation number two. The east line of section 10 is denoted on the picture as the red line. On the north of the line, Joe owns it. On the south of the line, Tom owns it. The California DOT takes 25 feet of Joe's property, and the California DOT takes the 25 feet of Tom's property, making a road 50 feet in width in 1990. And let's say they take it by deed. Now, I don't care whether this is by fee or by easement, because we're going to assume Joe and Tom are still alive. So the roadway project blows up, and the DOT says this road's a joke. They cancel the easement. Go to court, cancel the easement, gone. At the time, before the California DOT showed up, Joe had a fee simple interest, and Tom had a fee simple interest in their parcels. When the California DOT took their property, all they took was an easement. So from 1990 all the way to today, Joe and Tom had and still have a fee simple interest in the roadbed, but the DOT got an easement to use their property. Joe and Tom are still paying taxes on the roadbed. Joe and Tom still get to use the roadbed, hopefully. But now the easement is canceled and Joe and Tom's property is no longer encumbered. Now, this is a more advanced legal concept, so it may take yourself some time to get your mind around this. But do not go into the FS exam without understanding this, because it's a common question. Okay, now we come time to our answer choices. And remember, only one answer choice can be correct. So let's go back to our deal. So a roadbeds in the country are being abandoned. Tell me about the roadbeds being abandoned. So once the roadbed is abandoned, the land will be held in trust for the public. No. Once the roadway is abandoned, the land reverts back to its original owners, their heirs, or the current parcel owners, depending on the circumstances. Maybe. Next, the land is kept in government ownership for future use, sale, lease, or otherwise. When the government abandons a road, do they get to keep the road, land? No. So A is out, C is out. And last but not least, once the roadways are abandoned, the land reverts back to the current parcel owners adjoining the right-of-way. Now, that is correct in some circumstances, but not in all. So A and C are total garbage. Throw them out. D is an okay answer, but it's not complete. So I am going to have to go with B, because that is a complete answer, and it follows both situations depending on the circumstances.